Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. This is the Shrimpy Miggy channel. My name is Helen. You are so very welcome here. Today I wanted to make a video about the most frequent question that I get asked. Those of you who have known me for a while, thank you so much for following. And those of you who are new here, welcome. I hope you subscribe so that you can keep up to date with my Rogaine journey as I continue to talk about it and show different things about it and share the questions that I get. I decided to make this video about the most frequent question that I get because I've noticed definitely a theme. And as you guys may or may not know, I'm always welcome to your questions here. You can drop me any kind of question that you want in my comments. You can get in touch with me on Instagram, and I have a link to that below in the description box, and you can slide, just roll up in my DMs and drop me a question there. But I get questions on now almost every day about Rogaine, and I notice there's one that keeps popping up, and that is, what do you do about hair loss falling out when you first start using Rogaine? Or rather, the way I usually get it phrased is, did you have a lot of your hair fall out when you started using Rogaine? Before I answer that question, although I have answered everybody individually about that, let's just talk a bit about Rogaine itself and how it works and what the drug says that it does. And when I say Rogaine, I also of course mean minoxidil, the generic stuff. It works, it's the same drug. Theoretically, it works the same way. What I wanted to say about it is, well, first of all, let me just preface this by saying I'm not a doctor, I'm not a dermatologist, I'm not somebody who specializes in hair loss at all. I am just a woman who has had really great success with Rogaine on her own. I will insert an image, and I apologize to those of you who've seen these images, these before images, but I feel like they're kind of cool to look at. So I'm gonna insert an image of what my hair looked like over a year ago now, and now I'm just going to bend my head a bit so you can have a look. See that it's really, really filled in nicely. I'm really happy. I don't feel like I have any really visible bald spots. Rogaine has worked really, really well for me. I am definitely a success story. This video is 100% not sponsored by Rogaine. This is not an ad, this is just the stuff that I've noticed and the questions that I keep getting. Did it cause the dreaded shed for me? Apparently the nickname for this is called the dread shed, or the dreaded shed, where apparently a ton of your hair falls out when you start using Rogaine. But why does that happen? And so I think that for some people, they don't understand why that happens, and so it makes them nervous that all of their hair is gonna fall out. And definitely Rogaine has an explanation for that, which I'm going to read to you, and minoxidil does too, and also what you're supposed to do if that does happen. So it's not like you just start to use it, all your hair falls out, and then you're bald. I think that that's what women, or it makes your bald spot 20 times worse. I think that that's what women are afraid of, and I'm not gonna say that never happens. I certainly am not an expert about all the side effects that could happen with Rogaine. In my own experience, and just from the lot of stuff that I've read and all the women that I've heard from that it does work for, and all the forums that I read and my Facebook group, it hasn't happened like that. And let's just look at what Rogaine says though to try and figure out why, so we can understand what this shedding, this initial shedding of hair loss is and why it happens. I'll just drop in an image of the screen that I'm looking at here. And yeah. Okay, so on the Rogaine website, which I encourage you to look at if you're worried about side effects and stuff like that, it says, I just started using Rogaine products and I've noticed that my hair loss has increased. Is this typical? And so myself, I get this question all the time. Did your hair fall out like crazy when you started using it? So here's what Rogaine has to say. Rogaine products stimulate hair follicles to shift from the resting phase to the growth phase. So I'm not gonna bore you guys either with like telogenic phase, anagenic phase, like there are technical names for this, but your hair's not growing, like some hairs are resting and some hairs are gonna, all your hair's gonna fall out eventually anyway. I don't know if you guys know this, but every last hair of your head on your head has a life cycle and it will fall out and another one will take its place. And so let's just see what it says here. Thus, it is not uncommon to see a temporary increase in shedding during the first 2 weeks using Rogaine products. This occurs in some people as the new hair pushes out the older hairs when the hair follicle shifts into the growth phase. It's very much like losing baby teeth to make room for adult teeth. This increase in shedding is only temporary and should subside within a couple of weeks with continued treatment. Please note, however, if increased shedding continues for longer than 2 weeks, you should consult your doctor to rule out other possible medical problems. So there we have it. Yes, your hair could fall out more, and I have heard women definitely say they've had lots of hair fall out when they started using Rogaine. Did I? I did not experience this at all. But I was in a phase of losing quite a bit of hair at the time. It definitely did not increase the amount of hair that I was losing at all. But I was at that phase where I was like in the shower, and that's where we tend to notice it, where lots and lots of hair was coming out. That definitely did not stop when I started using the Rogaine, but I can't really say it was worse either. It was just kind of pretty steady. So speaking of that topic, if you want to have a look at losing less hair in the shower, I've made a video about that too, so definitely you want to check that out. These are just some tips to like just sort of lessen the trauma of seeing so much hair come out in the shower. There's just a way you can switch up doing your conditioner. So I will link to that. Be sure to give that video a watch as well if that interests you. But in my case, no, it didn't increase hair fall. I didn't get the dreaded shed from Rogaine or minoxidil. And so I just want to talk now a bit about what I've heard other women saying, just my impressions on the whole thing. I have heard just two different things about Rogaine and initial hair shedding. And the first one that I hear from women is just that Rogaine didn't work for them. Like, it just didn't fill in any bald spots. I don't think that anybody said that it's made it worse at all. And from the many, many women, I'm not saying that this didn't happen. And if this did happen to you, let me know. Drop a note in the comments. I'm very open-minded about this. I'm not just gonna say, that doesn't happen, or what Rogaine says is definitely gonna work for everybody. Like, no, those are just instructions for most people. But the thing to remember is they give you a time frame, right? 2 weeks. So if you're using it for 2 weeks and let's say you get a lot more hair loss, then just walk yourself on over to the doctor and see what's up. You know, I'm not a healthcare practitioner, and sometimes you'll need blood work done or your doctor will want to have a deeper look at what's going on with you. I definitely cannot give you that kind of medical advice here. I can only sort of just talk about my own experience and what I've gone through and the majority of what I've seen and read online. So yeah, I do hear from women that Rogaine didn't work for them at all. So that's the number one thing that I hear when it comes to like the hair falling out. But I've never heard of people saying, oh my God, yeah, I used it and way more hair fell out and it never grew back. The other most common comment I've heard about using Rogaine and initial hair shed was like, yes, it does cause hair to fall out, but then that hair gets replaced by other hair. And Rogaine literature says that, and when I say literature, I just mean like the sheet that you get when you buy like Rogaine, or like if you look on their FAQ site on their website, the hairs that do come back should be thicker than they were before. So that's sort of how Rogaine is supposed to work anyway. So yeah, I mean, I hope that's helpful. The bottom line was no, I didn't get any extra hair loss. Thank goodness. I don't actually have any side effects really that to report, not even really excess facial hair. So I've been really lucky. It's just done nothing but work well for me. So whatever number of people that is, that happens to be me as well. So I'm super lucky, but open to hearing your stories as well. Of course, I would say, you know, I can't really give you medical advice, but friend to friend, if you were to ask my opinion, I would tell you, you know, you could start to use it and you have what they say there, which is 2 weeks in. If you're like feeling your hair loss exacerbated, then just go in and see your doctor. I mean, you have that backstop there. You're not supposed to just use it until every last hair falls out and then freak out that Rogaine made you lose all your hair. They have like a really short timeline there for you to try and get it, to see what happens in that timeline. It's not just like over 3 months or 6 months, which I think is what people believe. Like you'll just keep losing your hair over 6 months. No, 2 weeks. And that's it. You shouldn't be losing more hair according to this after a couple weeks. Just check with an expert though about that, like your doctor. Okay, everyone, thanks so much. I hope that was helpful. If it was, remember to like and subscribe, and I'll see you here soon. Bye.